Hello everyone, it's time to look into the final game of the Sri Lankan Tour of England. It's the one and only T20. I'm Shruti Chopra, the tarot reader, and I have the super special cricket analyst Sunil Chaudhary, who seems to be doing well with his Euro Cup predictions. Hey there, how's it going?
Hey Shruti, thanks for that wonderful introduction. How's it going for you?
It's going good, but I'm not so sure about the Sri Lankans, but I bet they will be celebrating at the end of this game. Their ordeal will finally come to an end. But we'll get to them in a bit. Sunil, how will England approach this one?
Well, for a moment, I thought you were already predicting that Sri Lanka will win the game. But speaking about England, 8 matches have been played on this tour so far. And England have won 5, tied 1, drawn 1, and there was that one rained off abandoned game. Another victory here, and they'll be sending the Sri Lankans home back winless, an eventuality that looked only one of the many possibilities at the start of the tour. Looking at T20 cricket in particular, England trailed Sri Lanka 3-4 on head-to-head. But coming off a win against them in the World T20, a tournament where they had managed to make it to the final as well. So, well, England look in a good spot here.
Absolutely. And England have suddenly been looking good with white ball cricket too.
Yes, that's what we've been talking about all summer. You know, for the first time in many years, there's a sense of invincibility in white ball cricket for England. Traditionally, a format that hasn't been their forte. And they should be able to carry through to this one-off game as well. Interestingly, and probably a topic for another day, England assistant coach Paul Farbres only recently boasted that England have more than 20 players who can all make it to the starting 11 and win the white ball internationals. So whether it's overconfidence straight out of the English national football team's books or really a new dawn that has been upon us when it comes to English cricket, we should be able to find out over the next few months or so.
Well, what about their players?
There are a few changes made to the squad. David Malan, Liam Dawson, Sam Billings, and Tymal Mills have all been brought in for this T20 International. I would love for England to try out all these players for this one game. And we've all seen what Billings is capable of in his stint for the Delhi Daredevils. And those following the NatWest T20 Blast would have seen Malan bat as well at the top of the order. But I'm most interested in the quick bowler Mills. At one stage, he was tipped to be the quickest in the country before injuries ended his first-class career. But now he wants to ply his trade as a T20 specialist, and that could make for an interesting sight coming into this match. Shruti, what about England's flaws? Will they come to the forefront in this game? What do the cards say?
Well, if I go looking for flaws, I'll be nitpicking, and that would be so very unfair. They have done a lot of things right in this entire time, but Tyro never fails to give further advice. So, taking forward from what you've said, Tyro agrees, England should take a chance and experiment with their team and its combinations. This will give them much needed exposure, especially to the ones who haven't been able to step up or who haven't had that sort of experience. Now, specifically to their performance, their innings show good team contributions and a commanding style of play, but initial bowling could be expensive. But will Sri Lanka use this to their advantage and help their momentum? We'll have to wait and watch. Speaking of Sri Lanka, what is going on with them? Everything that could go wrong for Sri Lanka seems to have gone wrong for them then.
Yes, it has. Angelo Matthews has come out admitting the team has been outplayed in every department of the game during the tour. But he's also said that he won't be running away from the leadership roles. And that will be a bit of a relief for the board, because it doesn't look like they have too many waiting in the wings ready to take over the captaincy. It should also give the team a bit of a lift, knowing that the captain is himself in the trenches with them.
Well, how much will a win in this game mean for Sri Lanka?
Well, a win is a win is a win, Shruti. We all know how much we crave for wins in sports, and especially the fans. But it's coming to the end of a long tour, and one in which they have had a fair share of their struggles. So I'm quite sure they'll want to prevent England from making a clean sweep. But the big question for them is, will they have the mental strength to do that?
And which Sri Lankan players will show that mental strength you're referring to?
Well, a few youngsters have shown the odd flashes of brilliance in the ODIs, but look at the ODI batting charts, and it's all down to the two senior men again, Captain Matthews and stand-in captain and probably the vice-captain Dinesh Chandimal, both scoring more than 250 runs over those 5 ODIs. We'll be down to them yet again for Sri Lanka. Shruti, you spoke about the opportunity Sri Lanka will be presented with in your previous segment. Do the cards see their batsmen making use of it?
Well, somewhat. Sri Lanka's batting will be quite patchy, and despite recognizing the opportunities, they will not have the best application. In fact, their entire innings is appearing to be quite inconsistent. If they could just improve their focus, they could make this a good game, but I'm doubting it, more because their bowling, despite being fairly decent, may not be able to generate some deserving wickets. Luck may just not be on their side. Now, Samir, on to the predicting part. Is England your favorites for this?
I find it very difficult to say that England are not favourites going into the match. But looking at some of the records at the Rose Bowl in Hampshire, where this game is going to be played, looks like the team batting first has a huge advantage. So that's something that people might want to look at as well. Shruti, your call. Are you going to surprise us with a Sri Lankan victory prediction?
Yes, I am going to surprise you, Sunil. I'm going to go with the home team. It's tarot advantage England.
Hardly a surprise, Shruti. But that's all we have for today and for this series and for the tour. But the CPL continues, so do subscribe and keep listening in. Bye.